Now comes the basic thing is security. This chapter is about security with respect to CodeIgniter. We saw many things, models, views, various architecture, implementation with session management, cookie management, temporary data, flash data, many more things. But now important thing, whenever you develop a web application is to understand that whether your application is actually secured or do we need some other kind of amendments in it. So that's what is CodeIgniter security all about. So first thing we'll start with excesses prevention. So what is excesses? It's nothing but cross-site scripting thing which happens in all web application framework. Point by point we'll go for the security perspective, starting with the cross-site scripting. So let's start with the first point. CodeIgniter comes with this filtering capacity of cross-site filtering. Okay, this filter, it includes an inbuilt filter in it. So this filter helps you to prevent any kind of malicious JavaScript functionality if anything is there. If you see for Gmail servers or many other mail servers, it does not allow you to send .js file because JavaScript are more prone to have any kind of malicious code which can be prone to viral attacks and many other things. So CodeIgniter has that functionality, okay? It removes this part. Whenever you put a code of CodeIgniter in the server end, okay, it filters the excesses part, that is the cross-site scripting functionality. Okay, so this filter will remove the JavaScript code, malicious code if it detects anything, and it will this kind of filtering will help you to keep it in a protective manner. Why this malicious code is important to be kept aside? Because these codes helps you to hijack cookie and do any kind of malicious activity. This activity can be hacking or getting inside the code or any kind of the viral attacks. So that is what it does. The basic thing is that it includes a function name XSS underscore clean. This will help you to clean all the data. Okay. So this is what is the first step which we start with the security point of view, which every website development faces. If you're a web developer, you launch a website, you are prone to have such kind of issues in it. So CodeIgniter helps to filter this out in the initial step only. So you don't have to worry about that part. The next come is the SQL injection prevention. What is SQL injection? SQL injection is nothing but it is an attack which is done on the database query. We have MySQL over here. It can have a set of queries, many more things which is possible with respect to SQL injection thing. So CodeIgniter has that thing that it helps you to remove this SQL injection part with a simple PHP function, that is MySQL underscore real underscore escape underscore string. This function will help you to remove that part. But this is like which is already present in Code PHP as well. There is something distinguishing with respect to CodeIgniter also. That's what. CodeIgniter has various inbuilt function which helps you to create the queries which is like limited access and which will not at all allow in any possibility to have any SQL injection in it. So that is like done with three ways. First is like you have to escape your queries. You have to bind your queries. This is the second part. And active record class. The way we call a query in our model. So let's go to code base. There I'll show you what is active record class all about. So this is my model. Okay, so I'll move to my model. First of all, inside application, I have models. I have some code inside it. So this code, okay, calling like set data where update. So active record class is nothing but this one. The CodeIgniter has this set of queries. This will not help SQL injection to implement in it. SQL injections are very firm when it comes to understanding the basic SQL like select star from student and so on. But here you can't see any set of queries in that like insert into or select. So that is not possible over here. So that's why active record class is again a plus point which helps you to escape the queries and escape any kind of SQL injection in it. So that is like the second security step which CodeIgniter provides. The next come is CSRF prevention. What is CSRF? Is nothing but cross-site request forgery prevention. Okay, so you can prevent this attack by enabling it inside config.php. So again, moving R to our code base, we'll move to our code base where I'll call for my config.php file. So here I have my config.php file and I'll call for the CSRF protection function. So that is CSRF underscore protection. So this is CSRF underscore protection. It's already defined in the configuration folder. You just have to set this as true. This true parameter will help CodeIgniter to analyze that, okay, I have to increase my cross-site request forgery. And the other parameters which are given for CSRS, once it's set true, we need to give these parameters as well. That is the token name, associated cookie name, the expiration date, regeneration should be true or not, or any kind of the URIs if anything is present on it. So this is what is the main thing. So this was regarding the cross-site forgery thing. The last but not the least step for CodeIgniter is the password handling. So let's have a look like how password handling should be maintained. So as you see, there are many developers who do not know how to handle password in web applications. Okay, so which is probably why numerous hackers find it so easy to break into the systems and get inside the password and hack your complete system from the scratch. So it happens in such a way that it happened for LinkedIn also. Websites like LinkedIn also gets hacked because of such kind of any irresponsible thing which we do. So password handling should be followed with some set of rules, some set of protocols should be kept in mind. First thing, do not share your password in plain text format. It is always beneficial to keep a password in MD5 or any kind of the encrypted format. So this will help you to save your database also, and any user cannot grab the password very easily. So that is like the first step. Second, always hash your password. So hash your passwords is nothing but encrypt your password with the specified algorithm. So that would be your second step. Do not use Base64. Why I am mentioning not to use Base64? Because Base64 is a very simple thing. Anyone can encode and decode and check for the password and get the output. So instead of Base64, move on to something new set of algorithms, say for example MD5 or any other set of algorithms in it. Next, do not use any set of weak or broken hashing passwords. It is always beneficial to use strong passwords. Strong passwords can be like alphanumeric passwords with some special characters combinations. So these passwords can be easily to hack. If you use your standard password, say example for your mobile number or your husband's name or something like that, it's quite easily to crack and any user can get an access to it. So it is better to always use a password which is strong enough, and hashing algorithms should be kept so that these passwords can be hashed appropriately and saved in database so that any kind of the issues will be avoided in our system. So this was this third point. The next is, you should never display your password or send your password in the plain text format. The password should be saved and protected accordingly, and it should be never shared to the other users. Okay, if anything you need to share it, it should be strongly kept in the protected format, that is in the encrypted format, such that encryption with respect to key perspective should be there, so that the decryption should be evolved with the same key so that any user cannot decrypt it easily. So these all parameters is very important to be taken place. CodeIgniter obviously supports these all parts, but you need to keep each and every step in the particular manner. After that comes the last point, that is, do not put unnecessary limits on user's password. Some limits are there. For example, there are some websites which keeps that, okay, you should have two special characters with two special symbols and many more things. You should never keep it, because if you want to keep your web application user friendly, you should allow a user to set a password on his own way. This doesn't mean that user can set any kind of the password and keep it, and which will help to hack the password. Obviously, some rules should be kept in mind, but that should not be kept in a very limited stage that no, your password strength should be 11 or your password strength should be 8 or so on. So these all limitations should be removed. This is like as per my suggestion. You should remove all these inside your system and completely keep your password to be password protected with encryption point of view, so that if anything happens in future, you will have a key in your hand. With respect to that key only, you can help to like decrypt the password and open minimize system. So these all functionalities takes place when it comes to security module CodeIgniter project. Now we'll move to the next level of the chapters, like understanding various parameters, file uploading, form handling, error handling measurements. So these all measurements should be maintained with the security perspective, so that every user can keep in mind that yes, security is the first priority which should be kept while developing a web application.